Well, okay. I have opinions on this. First, is prompt engineering engineering? I've got thoughts on this. But let's talk about whether it's a basic skill. In order to interact with a generative AI system, you need to be able to write a description of what you want. There is a very simple name for that skill, and it's called giving good instructions. Giving good instructions is a foundational skill that is phenomenally useful if you're a human. It is how you're a good leader. Imagine a leader who cannot give good instructions, right? A general who can't give good instructions, a CEO who can't give good instructions, a president who can't give good instructions, or at least someone on their team can give good instructions if they can't do it, right? Someone's got to give good instructions. Otherwise, the whole organization is going to go off and do stupid things. A teacher has to give good instructions, otherwise their students won't learn. A programmer has to give good instructions, otherwise the code that they write, which is literally instructions for the machine, won't work. We have to give one another good instructions, otherwise what we want to happen won't happen. We have to give our spouses good instructions if we want things to get done, say, around the house. We need to know how to give good instructions. And, by the way, as part of giving good instructions, you know what else we need to know? We need to be able to tailor our instructions. A leader who gives their instructions the same way to every single person they're trying to give instructions to is not that great of a leader. You might notice some wobbles in the charisma if there is no tailoring. So the skill of giving good instructions involves tailoring it to the situation. If I try to give you the same instructions as I'm giving in my Python code, it's not going to work. I'm going to waste a lot of time writing it at you in Python as opposed to speaking it at you, which is the best way to communicate with you. So that fundamental skill, I think a lot of us have it already, and it does not hurt to train it. Prompt engineering, a lot of it is that. Here's a new thing. How does it work? Okay, how do I give it instructions? How do I see, right, based on these instructions I've given it, what did it do? Did I like what it did? No. Okay, how do I adjust my instructions so that it does something better next time? How do I adjust my instructions so it does something better next time is what we're also asking as teachers. We might not get it right the first time with this student that we're tutoring. Okay, now we gotta adjust. So that is prompt engineering. Some of us are better at it than others. Doesn't hurt anybody to learn it. That said, I find myself thinking back to the 11th century. Yes, I'm going to go that far back, to the 11th century. And this mathematician who made great contributions to the field of mathematics, Omar Khayyam, he wrote that he was completely stumped by finding the roots to the cubic equation. Now, finding the roots to the cubic equation is a high school exercise for the modern person. I'm sure you and I both learned how to find roots to a cubic equation. And so one would think, this giant, this intellectual giant that has made all these contributions, why can't he just find the roots to a cubic equation? How hard could that be? And then you see how he was trying to do it. And he was writing it all out like paragraphs. There's no symbolic notation, there's no pluses, there's no minuses. It's all this long stuff. A cube, blah, blah, blah. It makes no sense. It's all this loose stuff, and it made me think, we can do mathematics like that today, right? I've got a graduate degree in mathematical statistics, plenty of mathematics in there, so no one would have stopped me should I have wanted to do my graduate work by writing it all out in paragraphs as long as I got the right answer. But I wouldn't have. Why not? Because it's not precise. I would have gotten myself muddled. And so there's a very good reason why mathematics ended up condensing itself down to less expressive, more precise, where you're saying much less very precisely. So that we're not all over the place, we're not ambiguous. Because that's how you manage to maintain control of the instructions that you're giving. So that you're not saying one thing and simultaneously meaning 15 things. You can't make good progress like that. What we're doing with prompts is we are permitting ourselves to do the equivalent of writing it out in mathematics. And that's cute when we don't need to control what comes out on the other side. If we just want to get inspired, we're like, hey, write a poem in the style of John Milton about bananas, let's see what we get. But what if quality becomes important? Well, what you will see in prompt engineering is, at first, everyone was writing these short things and getting whatever. Then, people quickly started to realize that if you wanted control of your output, what did you have to do? Lengthen the prompt. Why are we lengthening the prompt? Because there's less ambiguity when it's longer. You're being much more precise about what you want. And then people were like, well, human language, it's still imprecise. What has more precision? Okay, let's control some of it with code. Let's start using code to wrap and define our prompt so we can have code-like structure that says, when I say these words, I mean this. When I say those words, I mean this. Okay, turn it all into a prompt where you can much more carefully control what the system's going to do for you. What we're actually doing is slowly but surely, each individually, as we are playing with getting better and better at prompting, is we're almost designing our own personal programming language, where we don't have to say like, ah, oh, Python, I have no other way to get it done. Maybe I like Python, maybe I hate Python, but you know, I gotta choose one of the existing ones and that's how I gotta express myself. Now we're like, okay, maybe I can, without building a programming language completely from scratch, I can kind of start defining my own that where it speaks more intuitively, more like me as a person. So it's more intuitive for me to write it, but I'm still gonna make it more and more precise. Like those of us who've been doing this prompt engineering thing for a little bit, we're pretty much coding with it. Unless we don't care and you just want some inspiration. Or write me a poem, I don't care what comes out. When you care, you reduce the ambiguity, you increase the precision, and that is legitimate engineering.